Hello, Glendale Community College Chem 130 students and other chemistry students. Today we're going to work on drawing chemicals in beakers of water, so what we call beaker drawings. Now, in order to correctly draw a beaker drawing, you need to know if what you're drawing is a strong, weak, or non-electrolyte. Now remember, a strong electrolyte ionizes about 100%, meaning it breaks apart into ions. A weak electrolyte ionizes only about 1 to 5%, meaning most of it stays together and just 1% actually breaks apart in solution. So most of it stays together. And then non-electrolytes ionize 0%. They stay together completely together. All right, so I think the best way to approach drawing these beaker drawings is to ask yourself three questions. First, is it an acid? Second, is it covalent? Third, is it ionic? Now, if it's an acid, your choices are either strong or weak. And in Chem 130, at least, you're supposed to know your acids and know if they are strong or weak. So that is something you need to memorize from the acid chapter. If it's not an acid, ask yourself if it's covalent. Do you remember what covalent means? Covalent is a molecule or compound made completely of nonmetals. And they are non-electrolytes. If it's covalent, you put it in water, it's a non-electrolyte, meaning it doesn't ionize at all, 0%. And then finally, if it's not an acid and it's not covalent, is it ionic? If so, it's either soluble or insoluble. How can you figure out if an ionic compound is soluble or insoluble? Well, guess what? We look at our solubility rules from our periodic table. Yay, we give them to you in Chem 130, which is wonderful. We don't give them to you in other classes, so you'll have to learn them. But we're going to look at our solubility rules today. If something is soluble, that means it gets an AQ after it. If it's insoluble, it gets an S after it. Soluble things are strong electrolytes, whereas an insoluble ionic compound is a weak electrolyte. So we're going to refer to these rules, and let's go ahead and start our beaker drawings. Here's the first one I want to try. H2SO4. So let's ask ourselves the first question. Is it an acid? Is H2SO4 an acid? Yes it is. So this is an acid, and then we are supposed to know if it is strong or weak. So H2S has a sulfur in it, so what's its name? You're right if you said sulfuric acid, because it has a sulfur in it, and H2SO4 is in fact a strong acid. So if it's a strong acid, what kind of electrolyte is it? Exactly, it's a strong electrolyte as well. And how much do strong things ionize? About 100%. So we're going to need to draw our H2SO4 in this beaker as soluble, ionizing, breaking up into ions. So how will H2SO4 break up into ions? Well, maybe you remember from our polyatomic ions that SO4 is a polyatomic ion, and it will stay together as a group. The SO4 will stay together. But the two H's are going to fall off, because that's what acids do. They make H plus ions in solution. So we are going to have two H pluses for every SO4, which has a charge of -2. And now I always recommend you draw at least three molecules in the water. So the molecule is again breaking apart because it's an acid. So let's draw another one. H plus, SO4, 2-, and one more. H plus, SO4, 2-. So that is my picture of sulfuric acid in a beaker of water. It's a strong acid, so it breaks apart completely, almost 100%. So the H's do pop off and make H plus ions, leaving the SO4 2 minus polyatomic ion left behind. So there's three of them broken apart into the water. It's all ions. That's one thing we need to remember about strong electrolytes. They are all ions in our picture. All ions, if you're strong, it's very important to remember. Your picture should have only ions in it if it's a strong electrolyte. Excellent. Let's try another one. Here we have SROH in parentheses 2. That is strontium hydroxide. Strontium hydroxide. All right, let's look at our questions. Is this an acid? Well, it doesn't have an H in front, so no, it's not an acid. Is it covalent? Covalent means non-metals only, but I see strontium. Strontium is an alkaline earth metal in that second column, so we have a metal. So it's not covalent. Is it ionic? We have a metal and a non-metal group, so yes, it is ionic. We have a metal and a non-metal. So, according to our cheat sheet, we need to find out if this is soluble or insoluble by looking at the solubility rules. So we are looking up strontium hydroxide in our solubility rules. Remember, we go by the first rule we see. So we're looking for strontium or hydroxide, OH. Rule number 1, no, 2, no, 3, no, 4, no, 5, no, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ah, 10 is about hydroxide. But calcium, strontium, and barium are soluble. Aha, strontium hydroxide is soluble, even though it's on the insoluble side because it's an exception. So this is soluble. So this is ionic and it's soluble. So what kind of electrolyte is it if it's soluble? Well, if we look back at our cheat sheet, soluble is a strong electrolyte. So this is strong. How much do strong things ionize? 100%. So this picture should be all ions again. All ions. It is a strong electrolyte. So how does this break apart? It's going to break apart because it's ionic and it's soluble. So it's going to break apart when we put it into that water. So we're going to have strontium, the metal, as an ion. What's its charge? Well, we just said strontium was in the second column. That's the plus 2 column. So strontium is going to have a plus 2 charge. Now hydroxide stays together because it's polyatomic. We don't separate into O's and H's. What's the charge on a hydroxide? Well, it's one of our polyatomic ions, hydroxide, and it has a minus 1 charge. And there are 2 of them for every strontium because we have to be charge balance. So strontium hydroxide breaks apart into a strontium ion and 2 OH ions. And again, I like to draw 3 of them, so there's 1 of them. Strontium plus 2, OH minus, OH minus. Strontium plus 2, OH minus, OH minus. So something like that. That is how we would draw strontium hydroxide because it is soluble. It is an ionic compound, so it dissolves into ions 100%. So our picture is a strong electrolyte with all ions in there. Everything broke apart. We have only ions in our drawing because it's strong. Good job. All right, let's move away from strontium hydroxide. Try another one. Here we go. C6H12O6. C6H12O6. Now, is this an acid? Well, we don't have an H in front, so no. Is it covalent, meaning it's non-metals? Well, C, H, and O are all non-metals, so yes, it is covalent. This is a covalent compound. What do we know about covalent? It's a non-electrolyte. Non. electrolyte. What do we know about non-electrolytes? Well, they ionize 0%. So that means there should be no ions in my picture at all. That means it stays bonded together. Stays bonded together. There are no ions in my picture. So I'm just going to write the formula. C6H12O6, 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 which by the way is a sugar. Yeah, sugars don't conduct electricity in water. They don't break apart into ions. They stay together. So make sure you draw them staying together. Okay, there shouldn't be a lot of space between the C's, the H's, and the O's, because that makes it look like they're coming apart, and they're not. Okay, sugars are covalent. They are non-electrolytes. There are no ions in your drawing. It all stays together. Excellent. All right, we've got two more left. Let's try this one. HF. Is HF an acid? Well, it does have an H in front, so yes, it is an acid. We're supposed to know our acids. Do you remember the name for HF? You're correct if you said hydrofluoric. Yes, it is an acid. Now, we're supposed to know if an acid is strong or weak in this class. What is HF? Do you remember? It is weak. It is a weak acid. How much do weak things ionize? Well, weak electrolytes ionize about 1-5% only. So most of HF stays together. Only 1-5% is going to break apart. So we need to show this as a lot of HF staying bonded together. So I'm going to do HF, HF, HF. HF, HF, HF. I drew 6. So I drew a lot showing that it stays bonded together. Now 1-5% breaks apart. That's all. So in this drawing, I'm just going to do 1. Just do 1 molecule apart. HF is going to break into H plus and F minus. So it is an acid. It made some H+, just not a whole lot of H+. Let's compare that with our strong acid. Wow, look at all the H+ is in the strong acid. That's why it's strong. It made a lot of H+. The weak acid just has 1. Okay, so again, this is a weak electrolyte. It's a weak acid. Most of the add the compound stays together, most of the molecules stay together, and only 1 breaks apart. So this is an acid. A weak acid looks like this. Most of it floats around together. Just draw 1 apart. Great. All right, last one. PbSO4. What's the name for that? Well, most of you may know Pb is lead here in column 4, which means its charge varies. It can be a +4 or a +2 because it's in that fourth column. So let's look at this. It's bonded to SO4, sulfate. SO4 is a polyatomic ion with a -2 charge. So if SO4 is -2, the lead must be a +2 because ionic compounds have to be neutral. So this is lead to sulfate. Just for fun, we're naming that compound. And I may have gotten a little bit ahead of myself here. Let's go back to our checklist now. Is it an acid? Well, no, we don't have an H in front. Is it covalent? Well, no, I already pointed out we had a metal, lead. So is it ionic? Yes, it is. This is ionic. Well, what are we supposed to do with ionic? We're supposed to see if they're soluble or insoluble by looking at our solubility rules. So let's grab our solubility rules. We are looking for lead or sulfate, whichever we come to first. Rule number one, no, two, no, three, no, four, no, five is about sulfate. Sulfates are typically soluble, except there's a but. Calcium, strontium, barium, silver, and lead are insoluble. We have lead sulfate, so it is actually insoluble. So, insoluble ionic compounds mean they get an S. Mostly they're solids. An insoluble ionic compound is a weak electrolyte. So this is weak. Weak electrolyte. Weak electrolytes ionize about 1 to 5%. So there's a few ions, but most of this is going to stay together. Most of it's going to stay together. Okay, it's weak. Lead 2 sulfate is weak. So let's go back to the cheat sheet. I said soluble ionic compounds get an AQ because they dissolve in water, but insoluble get an S for solid. So that means most of the lead sulfate is actually a solid. Now there's a cheat way to show if something is a solid. You do a squiggly line at the bottom and put PbSO4 down in there. This tells me 95% or more is down here in the solid state. So there's actually hundreds of PbSO4s down here, thousands if not millions of PbSO4s down here in the solid state. Okay, and only 1 to 5% dissolve, so we're only going to draw one that dissolved and is broken apart up here in the solution. So we got the Pb, we got the SO4. Remember, sulfate is a polyatomic ion that stays together. Now lead, we just said it was a plus 2 because the sulfate is a minus 2. And we have to have our ionic compounds add up to 0. Plus 2 minus 2 equals 0. So this is how a weak ionic insoluble compound looks. Most of it is down at the bottom. This little squiggly line means 95% or more is down here at the bottom. We only draw one apart. Most of this stays together and sinks to the bottom. Just a little bit is dissolved up in the solution. So this is weak. Let's compare this to the weak acid now. They're both weak, but this is an ionic compound. This is an acid. So they're not the same. Acids float around in solution and one breaks apart. For an ionic compound that's weak, most of it sinks to the bottom and one breaks apart. So the weak acid and the weak ionic compound are different. Okay, let's go back to our cheat sheet. So we saw several examples today of acids, a strong one, a weak one. We saw a covalent molecule as well, a sugar, and we saw a soluble and an insoluble ionic compound and how to draw them in beakers of water. I hope this helps you with drawing your beaker drawings. Good luck. See you next time.